Hi, in the earlier lecture, we have seen how to create a new project within Jenkins and what is the plugin that is going to facilitate us to visualize the report. Let us have a quick check whether everything is in place. I do have the project and the configuration for this specific project is yet to be done. And before that, let's go ahead and check the plugins whether it is in place. Support of manage plugins under installed tab. I do have the plugin warnings, next generation plugin. In case if you are okay to go with the earlier version of Checkstyle, you can do the installation, but this is going to have more security features. So I'm going with the latest plugin warnings, next generation plugin. Now let me go ahead and do the configuration of the project. So I'm getting into the project that we had created, and I have created a small project as a part of a GitHub where I have put in the source code sample.java. So I do have a small method and I have the check style configuration sun checks.xml where it is going to do the check against the sun standards. And as a part of build.xml, I have put in the target check style where it is going to pick the configuration file, that is sun checks.xml, as a part of the root location, and on violation it is not going to fail, it will continue. And I'm going to look for all the projects with the extension .java within the source directory, and the output will be in the name of checkstyle-result.xml and it will be in the format of an XML file. So I do have the source code and I do have the build script, that is build.xml, to be used with and I do have the check style configuration sunchecks.xml. So I'm going to copy the git URL within the project. Let me go ahead and do the configuration. I can provide any description or I can make the Jenkins to read the description or details about the project from the GitHub location. And I'm going to have the source code from this specific location. I'll select git. So it will provide the option to fill the git URL. I'll provide the git URL. And it is from the GitHub and no authentication required. So directly it can go ahead and read the file. In case if any authentication needs to be done, I can provide the credentials. And build, I am not going to make it to trigger automatically. Manually, I'll be triggering it. Do the build using ant. I will provide the target check style. So that is the target that we are setting within the build.xml. Within build.xml, I'm going to trigger this specific target check style. And post build action, I have selected the static analysis tool. Let me show how to select this. Add post build action, record compiler warning and static analysis result. And select the check style tool here. In case if the output is of different format, I can mention the format of the output or the pattern to match the output file. I have the setting to have the output stored as a part of the file name checkstyle-result.xml. That is the default value this particular tool is going to look for, so I don't need to fill any values. And I can aggregate the results from multiple tools as well, where I have the option to add multiple tools and aggregate the results. And whether to enable the recording for the failed build as well, I can go ahead and do the configuration. I don't need to make any configuration changes. In case if I want to override, I can go ahead and override over here. With all these configuration changes, that is the git URL, build task, and I have selected ant build, and I am going to execute the target check style. And post build action, I have done the configuration for check style tool. Now let me go ahead and save this specific project. And I can trigger the build manually from this specific location, build now. So the build will get triggered. I can get into the build and see the configuration changes through the console output. So it's going to connect to the GitHub, get the latest source code and trigger the check style target using the build. So the ant target check style is getting triggered and the build is successful. Once it is success, it is going to provide the option to visualize the result. Here it's giving the summary. There are 4 issues available within this specific file. Let me go ahead and get back to the project. So within the project, I do have the option check style warnings. It will provide a beautiful UI where what are all the errors available, what are all the details about the error in terms of what category it belongs to, what type of error, what are all the issues available, and in which file, what type of issue it is. Now it is up to the DevOps team or the developers to decide what to do against these errors, whether to proceed with the build and deployment or communicate with the developers to do the fix of these errors. By navigating through the issues, each and every issue, I can get the details about what are all the issues and what are all the solutions available. It is going to provide the possible solutions as well. And by getting into the specific file, it can provide the exact location where the issue is available and what issue it is. It's very clearly saying missing a Java doc comment. So I can go ahead and add the Java documentation and execute this specific run once again. Now let us have a quick try on how to fix this particular Java file. Let's try to fix by adding a small comment against this particular method. So I'm going to provide a Java documentation. I have added a comment against this specific method, should be warning, and executed the build once again. Let me check the report. So after executing the report, the number of error gone down by 1, and I can see the historical trend on the bugs as well. And it's going to highlight what are all the errors available. Even while fixing it, if any bugs made by the user, that will get highlighted very immediately. Let's make a small change to this specific code by introducing a non-standard comment. Say I'm going to remove this full stop and commit this specific code. As per the standard, the last line should end with the full stop within the comment. Let's go ahead and run the build once again. We get back to the project and build now. The build got over. Let me check the checkstyle warnings. We can see the historical trend where number of bug got increased by 1. We can go back and check what that specific bug and why it happened. Let me get into the specific file and check. It says first sentence should end with a period. So I can go ahead and do the fix. By this way, Checkstyle going to have the complete control on the code development during the development phase as well as during the build phase, and it will make sure the code is adhering to the standard throughout the life cycle of the project. So we have seen how to configure the project, how to execute the project as well as do the build, and how to check the Checkstyle warnings and visualize the report.